Mustang got a Rolls-Royce Griffin engine and was designed to answer a Royal Navy specification for an engine capable of generating good power at low altitude. It's very reminiscent that perhaps many scenes observed by people along the south coast of Britain during those difficult days of 1940. And that wonderful elliptical design there showing off the real grandeur of the Spitfire day farm. Companies presenting the Spitfire to make a new engine as we got as far back as May 1939. And this is James Smith very much getting involved with that, not the famous aviation name. He was pretty straightforward. He just said, well, the good one would eventually beat the good old little one. The Rolls-Royce company is very much tied to R.J. Mitchell and his team, who developed the Spitfire down on the south coast. The first flying of all back in 1946. Sadly, our image did get to see the phenomenal success of the Spitfire that certainly didn't appear into the eyes of the enemy. And it was very much to the Battle of Britain Memorial site a little later on in the first half of our display this afternoon. Was built at the end of 1944 at Seagull. It was initially stored until 1945 before being sent off to Lima and then to India. And here in China and India, details of the service that we've undertaken are very much lost in the mist of time. Very, very few records exist upon this particular aircraft. But it was never been built in the early 70s. The first part of the UK collection was restored in 92. In the other Spitfire, a classic Mark V. The Mark V and the Mark IX are very much the backbone of the Spitfire fleet in terms of its fighting capability. This one built by Western Maneuver in Somerset and took to the air in September 1942. The Spitfires were very much undergunned with just the 8 machine guns. From here on, with this particular mark, 4 20mm cannons to be added, or a mixture of 4 303 machine guns and 2 7mm cannons. But of course, it's that cannon that gave them the extra fighting weight. The Mark V seated with a Rolls-Royce Merlin 46 engine, producing 1,400 horsepower. It was essentially a measure set 109U with a British Rolls-Royce Merlin engine. Spanish Air Force operating his aircraft right up until 9:55. Another brief on, nicknamed Red 11. The world's only surviving 1112, it's Mark ML4L. And three-seat dual control boost on, it was produced by the same company in the 50s again, also with a World War Merlin added. Now, this aircraft and the other boost on were put into storage, but all of them made airworthy again for the very famous Battle of Britain movement. At this stage that these aircraft were placed on the triple register under the ownership of the Spitfire Production Company. Red 11 actually went off to the United States to Texas for many, many years until it was brought back in 2015 by Air Leasing, the company. Thank you. But additionally, you can fly alongside and get experiences with them as well. It gives you the chance to get up close and personal with many of the single-seaters in the collection. Fly in formation with the Viking Hawker Fury, the T-27 Thunderbolt, the Hawker Hurricane, the Mustang, the Spitfire, and the T-27. The guy now, the great photo opportunity, a classic frame.